Hello, everybody. So what we're going to be doing today is we're going to be looking at sine and cosine values with reference angles. And so in order to get started with that, we're going to have to look at what is a reference angle. So what is a reference angle? Question mark. So a reference angle is an angle, first of all, and it's a specific type of angle that is not so easy to describe unless you use the right language. So I'm going to have to do this. So a reference angle is the angle between 0 and 90 degrees. 0 degrees and 90 degrees. And maybe we should qualify this a little bit. It's 0 degrees and 90 degrees if you're in, what's it called? Degree mode. But if you're working with radians, then 0 radians is 0 degrees, and 90 degrees is pi over 2. So between 0 and pi over 2, if you're in radians, basically. So a reference angle is the angle between 0 and 90 that the angle, sorry, the terminal side, no, the terminal side of an angle in standard position, terminal side of an angle, come on. Angle in standard position makes with the x-axis. Okay, and so that's our definition of what a reference angle is. Okay, and makes a lot more sense with pictures and examples and stuff like that. So, there is kind of a formula that you can use, but before we do a formula, I just want to show you an example because you don't really need formulas for this. If you have a formula, that's fine, but you don't really need them. So, let's say I have an angle in standard position. Let's say that this angle is here. I'm gonna make that straight. That was the opposite of making straight. Okay, there we go. So there's an angle like that, and it needs to have a measurement that we know, and so I just need to make up a value here. Let's say that it looks about 35 degrees and that's 90. So I'm going to say that's 125 degrees. Okay, so that's the angle. That's the original angle, which, I mean, it's not called the original angle, that's just what I'm calling it. So that's the original angle theta. And what we want is the reference angle. So the question is, what is the reference angle for 125 degrees? All right, and that's where you go to the definition. So it says that we're looking for the angle between 0 and 90. So it's got to be between 0 and 90, and it's supposed to be the angle that the terminal side, of an angle in standard position makes with the x-axis. What that's saying is this angle here may be 125 degrees, but if it is, there's an angle over here that's between 0 and 90, right? There's an angle between 0 and 90 degrees. And this is the terminal side. And this is the x-axis. So that's the angle that we want. And so the question is just, how big is this angle over here? Right? And you should just be able to figure it out from the geometry of what's going on here, right? If this much is 125, then how much is this much? They add up to 180, right? So you should be able to see that the reference angle, which gets called different things, I don't know if the book calls it anything interesting, but I'll say theta r for r reference. In this case, it's the angle here, and so that's 180 degrees minus that 125 degrees. And so you work that out, and what do you get? 55? Is that it? I think so. So 55 degrees, and that's the reference angle. Okay, so the good thing is that this is not actually that hard to do. The bad thing is that every quadrant that you're in, the formula for it is different depending on, depending on the quadrant. So if you want to use a formula that you look up, then this is harder than you would, than it otherwise would be. Okay, so that's kind of the issue with this stuff. So do not play that video talking to the computer here, sorry. Continue, I need to go back.
Let's take a look at one more example where theta is negative.
It. Don't here talk to me,
Here we have theta
me.
Equals negative 125
Stop talking
degrees.
To me.
So from the initial
side
of the angle, we'll
stop
rotate
talking
clockwise
to me.
125 degrees.
I quit.
So rotate.
Okay, sorry. I don't want to watch somebody else's video. I'm trying to make this video. Okay, so that's what you get. And so depending on which quadrant you're in, there's formulas. So if you want to use a formula, then these would be the formulas. Right, so what are the formulas for a reference angle? Right? And I already said it depends on which quadrant theta is in. Which quadrant theta is in. All right, let's draw some pictures. So we need four. So I will just draw one and we'll steal it and copy paste it. Duplicate. Hey, okay. Four of them. Now we need to draw some angles on these. So if you have an angle over here, and that's where your theta is, then the reference angle is actually just going to be the same angle. Theta r is just theta, okay? Because it's already between 0 and 90 degrees in that case. If you're over here, actually maybe I'll just draw the angles. So there's theta down here. There's theta down here. There's theta. We can probably draw a better line than that one. Okay. So there's your thetas. Now the theta r's are, well, theta r here is here. And that's the same one that we already wrote. On this picture, theta r is right here, and theta r is 180 minus theta. I'm going to write that a little nicer. Theta r is 180 minus theta. Down here, this would be theta r. And so theta r is, well, it's actually going to be theta minus 180. And over here, the reference angle is right here. And theta r is going to be 360 minus theta r. Okay? And if you do this in radians, it's all the same type of thing, but if you do it in radians, then you don't say 180 and you don't say 360. You have to say it in the appropriate measurement. So over here, this would still be theta equals theta r equals theta. Here, this would be theta r equals pi minus theta in radians, right? Because pi is 180 degrees. Down here, this one would be theta r is theta minus pi. And this one would be theta r is 2 pi minus theta. Just realized that I wrote theta r, but that should have been theta. Okay, so those are formulas, if you want formulas. Now, like I said, the best way to do it is the way that we did this first example, where we just figured it out. Okay, but let's try an example. Find the reference angle for, 220 degrees. Right? So if that's your problem, you have to know where 220 is. I mean, you don't have to get it exact, you just have to have a general idea, right? So, I mean, you know that 90 is up here, 180 is over here, 270 is here, right? So, where is 220? It's got to be in here somewhere, right? Something like that. And that's theta is 220 degrees. So then you want the theta r. That'd be right here, right? And that's just what we show in this picture here. And so if you want to use the formula, you'd be using that formula. Theta r is theta minus 180. So we'll do it. So we'll say theta r is, what'd we say? Theta minus 180 degrees. So what's theta? It is 220 minus 180. So it is 40. Now, make sure you pay attention to the fact that we know that a reference angle has to be between 0 and 90 degrees. So you need to get an answer that's between 0 and 90, right? If you don't, you did something wrong. It needs to be 0 and 90. Okay? So there's a reference angle. Now, they're not all going to be in degrees. We know that some of them are going to be in radians. So let's do something in radians. I'll find a reference angle. I shouldn't say a reference angle, the reference angle. Find the reference angle for theta. Let's go, what do I want? How about 11 pi over 6? Okay. Now, first of all, if you're trying to find the reference angle for 11 pi over 6, you have to have some idea where that is. Otherwise, you're going to be in trouble. And so that's where you have to think back to coordinate plane here, right? So 0 radians is right here. And up here is 90 degrees, but we're not talking about it in degrees, we're talking about in radians. So this is pi over 2 is straight up. Pi is over here. 3 pi over 2 is down here, and then if you go all the way around, you get back to 2 pi, because 2 pi is all the way around a circle. Now, keep in mind that when you see this right here, 3 pi over 2, 3 over 2 is 1.5, right? So that's pi, 1.5 pi. So this is 1 pi, this is up here, this is 1.5 pi, and then this is 2 pi. So if I look at this angle here, if I'm looking at theta equals 11 pi over 6, I probably can look at 11 over 6 and think 11 over 6 is a little bit less than 2. Why can't I write that so it looks like an 11? 11 over 6 is a little less than 2. Right? Because 12 over 6 would be 2. So with that in mind, then this should be a little less than 2 pi, right? Because it's got a pi on it. So when I go to draw this, I'm pretty sure that it's a little bit less than 2 pi. So I'm going to draw it down here somewhere. And you don't even need to draw it in like a great place. You just need to get it on approximately the right place. Get it in the right quadrant and you're fine. So, you know, it's down here somewhere. And it's all the way around this way. And that's theta equals 11 pi over 6. Okay? So if you get that in the right quadrant, then you know where theta r is. It's right here. If you don't know, then you know you look at your pictures to see where theta r should be. So we're in the bottom right picture. So this is theta r. So you consult your formula, and your formula says that theta r should be, in degrees, it would be 360 degrees minus theta, but we are in radians, so it's 2 pi minus theta. And what's the theta? It's over here, right? 11 pi over 6. Okay, and you need to work this out. So you can do it by hand, or you could use a computer, right? If I use Wolfram Alpha for this, which I will, if it will let me, if you do 2 pi minus 11 pi over 6, just type it in, hit enter, and it'll tell you result pi over 6. Okay? Now, if you want to do it by hand, you can. What you'd have to do is get a common denominator here. So you would have to take this and you would take the 2 pi, the common denominator is 6, so you'd multiply by 6 over 6, minus 11 pi over 6. So then you get 12 pi over 6 minus 11 pi over 6, and of course you get theta r then is 1 pi over 6, which the computer told us, but, you know, I just rewrote it. And 1 pi over 6, you don't need the 1. So that's a reference angle, and what's it called? In radians. Now, what I'm going to post for you guys by the time this is up with your notes is I'm going to post a unit circle for you, and the unit circle is going to make your life a little bit easier here, because you're going to have, if I can make one big here, you're going to have one of these big, and you know, then you're going to be able just to find the 11 pi over 6 on here, and you know, figure things out from there. That's going to be very helpful. So can I save this? I don't know. Copy. Maybe I can put it in the notes too. I have no idea if that's possible. Let's try. View, paper, blah, 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 plus. It will not let me. No, come on, I can do it. I have faith. I just need to try harder. Download. Oh well. Oh, it will be in the notes. Not in the notes. It'll be in the next to the notes. Why is it so hard? I have to close that and then open it up. Open. Okay. Back to what we were doing. So that's reference angles. Okay. Now, once you have reference angles, that's, you know, fantastic, but you know, why do we care, basically, is going to be the question. Okay. And the reason we care about reference angles is because you're going to memorize a few specific values on the unit circle, and then we want to be able to use those values to come up with the sine and cosine for a lot of angles. So we want to memorize a couple of numbers only, but then we want to be able to use those few numbers that we memorized to do a lot of problems. Okay, so let's see. Let's try to draw a circle here. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this is 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this is 10. Okay, so if I go like that, I drew a perfect. That's amazing. I didn't even know it could do that. I drew a circle so bad that it didn't know I was even trying to draw a circle. Okay. There we go. So what I'm trying to do with this is put that right there. Perfect. I've drawn a perfect circle. All right. Now what are we going to do with that circle? So that's our unit circle. So what we're going to do is we're going to draw a couple of points on here. Okay, so there's a point right here. We're going to draw a point at, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 over here, right about there. We're going to draw a point at, let's see here. Where's 45 degrees? I don't know. I'll come up with it in a minute. About there. So I guess that's right there. And then one right there. Okay. So there's some points on my unit circle. Now, what are those points? So what they are important points. So this point right here on the unit circle is 1, 0. Okay, easy enough. This point right here, the next one up, is square root of 3/2, 1/2. The next one up from there is square root of 2/2, √2/2. The next one up from there is 1/2 √3/2. And then the one at the very top is going to be 0, 1. Okay, and those are important points to know. You're going to memorize those. Maybe you haven't memorized them yet, but you're going to. Okay, so we got a dot here. That. Got another one. Another one. Another one. Then the one there. Okay, so what are the angles? So we need to draw the angles on here so we can memorize them. So this angle right here, the first one, is theta is 30 degrees, or in radians, pi over 6. Okay? The next one up is theta equals 45 degrees, or in radians, pi over 4. The next one up is, let's see if I can draw it, theta equals 60 degrees, or pi over 3. And then the next one up is theta equals 90 degrees, or pi over 2. Okay, now what are you going to do with those? And of course, this first one here is theta equals 0 degrees, or 0 radians. Now, I realize that that's messy. That's why I'm going to post a better one for you guys, so you don't have to use my unit circle only. But let's just think about what this means. So if I use the unit circle, use unit circle to evaluate, and I'm just going to give you a couple of numbers here. So I'm going to say sine pi over 4, and then I'm going to say cosine pi over 3, and then I'm going to say tangent of 0, and then I'm going to say, oh, actually, sorry, we're in sine and cosine, so let's skip the tangent. Let's do a sine of, what can we do? Let's say pi over 6, and then let's do a cosine of 90 degrees. Sure, why not? So I did 3 in radians and then 1 in degrees, but that's fine. We can do that. All right. So you have to remember the formulas for these from the previous lecture, right? So how do we get sines and cosines from the unit circle? Well, the sine, if you remember correctly, is just going to be the y value. So all you have to do is look at the unit circle, find pi over 4. Where's pi over 4? Right, you got to find it on the unit circle. Here it is. Right, there's pi over 4. Once you find pi over 4, then you need the y value there. So what's the y value right there? Well, that's this point right here. So it's square root of 2, square root of 2. So what's the y value? Square root of 2 over 2. Right, for the next one, we've got cosine pi over 3. Cosine is just the x value. What's the x value? Well, we got to find pi over 3, right? We got to find pi over 3 first. So pi over 3 is here. So where's the x value? It's right there. So what's the cosine of pi over 3? It is 1/2, right? Next, we have sine of pi over 6. It's going to be a y value. What's the sine of pi over 6? Well, again, you just gotta keep finding them. So where's pi over 6? Here's pi over 6. What's the y value right there? 1/2. Okay, then we've got cosine 90 degrees. What's the cosine? It's the x value. What's the x value at 90 degrees? Well, where's 90 degrees? Right? So 90 degrees is up here. So what is the x value right there? 0, right? So if you have this unit circle drawn out, you can find all of these sines and cosines just from the values drawn on here. Now, it's not every angle, right? You can't use what I've drawn so far. If somebody asked you, what's the sine of 22 degrees? You know, like if somebody says, what's sine 22 degrees? No idea, right? If somebody wants to know the cosine of 3 pi over 7, no idea, right? Because those aren't on my picture. I've only got 30, 45, 60, 90. 0, 30, 45, 60, 90. So We can't do any angle from this, but we can do some specific angles. Okay? Now, that's great. What does that have to do with reference angles? Because we were talking about reference angles, weren't we? Well, if you think about it, these same angles here, right? Like the angles that you have in the first quadrant. So you've got all of these angles here, right? All of the angles in this quadrant, aren't they just the same pretty much angles as you're going to have in this quadrant? Right? And aren't those going to be the same ones that you're going to have in the next quadrant? Right? Color in the lines. I can do it. We'll go green again here. I feel like that's like the radiation symbol or something. It's not, though. I don't think. Okay. Right? So you have four quadrants, and you really can draw the same exact, what are they called, angles in each quadrant, right? So like I can take a line here and say, well, there's an angle that's 45 degrees in there, in that one. And there's an angle that's just like this 60 degrees there. And then there's one over here that's just like the 30 degrees. So there's three in there. There's going to be the same thing here. Really? Why you no draw a straight line? Okay, so I mean, those aren't drawn very well. But the point is that there's these angles here in every quadrant that are pretty much the exact same angles as we had in the first, not in the right place. Well, it's gone now forever. Okay, which means this is not in the right place. No, that's in the right place. Okay. Well, about to give up on drawing this here, which I guess you'll probably appreciate. How did I lose my axes? Does anybody know? Okay. All right, anyway, I'm gonna just erase these here. Wait, how did I lose? I lost everything? How much did I just delete? Okay, good enough. I'm not drawing the fourth quadrant, I don't care. Okay, so sorry. Let's get back to this. So the point is that we went 30, 45, 60, 90, and if you kept going, this would be 120 degrees in there. This is gonna be 150 degrees in there. What's the middle one gonna be? It's gonna be 90 plus 145, or it's gonna be 90 plus 45, which is 135 in there. And you've got 180. And then down this way, you're gonna have 210. And that really doesn't look like that is evenly spaced at all. Why is that like that? Okay, about like there. 210 degrees, and then 225 degrees, and then down here you're gonna have 240 degrees, 270 degrees. You're gonna have in here, if that's 45, then that's going to be 360 minus 45, which is 315 degrees. You're going to have about right there. It's going to be going to be 30, so that's going to be 300 degrees. Going to have one over here. That's going to be 360 minus 30, so that's going to be 330 degrees, right? So you've got all these angles here on the axis. And if you were trying to figure out the coordinates, it's going to be very easy. So, like, let's say I take a point right here. Which one's going to be easy to draw next to? None of them are. Let's say I take this one right here, where the 330. Okay, so 330 degrees. Now let's say I want to know what are the coordinates right here. Coordinates. What are the x and y coordinates at this point right here? Well, what you would do is you would say, well, isn't this point right here pretty much the same as 30 degrees up here? Aren't they, like, they look the same, right? What's different about them? The only thing that's different about them is that the y value is negative. They have the same x value, right? But the y value is negative on the one on the bottom. So if you wanted the coordinates, you would just copy the coordinates from here, square root 3 over 2, comma 1 half. The only difference is you got to make the y value negative because it's below 0 here. And that same thing happens for all of them, right? Like, ooh. If you're way over here at 225 and you want to know what the coordinates are right there, 225 is just like 45. What are the coordinates at 45? Square root 2, square root 2. So you go square root 2 over 2, square root 2 over 2. And then you just have to think about, should the x value be positive or negative? And should the y value be positive or negative? And down here, right, the x value is negative on the left and the y value is negative on the bottom. So that's negative and that's negative. So they're both negative, okay? So that lets you actually evaluate more of these trig functions, right? Because if I say now, what is the cosine of, what was that, 225? 225 degrees, I would be able to look at my unit circle and say, oh, well, the cosine is the x value. And at 225, the x value is negative square root of 2 over 2, right? What if I want the sine of 330 degrees? It's the y value here. What's the y value right there? It is negative 1 half. Okay, so that's why you want the unit circle. If you memorize just the values in that upper right quadrant, you can figure out a bunch of other angles. Now, here's what I'm going to suggest you do. Print out a unit circle. The PDF is linked right next to these notes, okay? I'm going to link it from a few places, but it's going to be linked on Canvas next to these notes. Okay, because look how bad my drawing is. That's pretty terrible, right? Wouldn't you rather have this one? Isn't that nicer? That's a lot nicer, okay? And you're gonna have one this good or better linked to you, right? So that's a unit circle. Now that we know what a unit circle is, let's see what they're going to try to make us do here. Okay, so one thing they're going to try to do is, first of all, they're not going to necessarily make you, like, come up with sine and cosine values on every problem. Some of them are going to be like this. Here's an example. in terms of a positive acute angle, acute just means less than 90, so positive acute angle, what is an expression for cosine 19 pi over 18? Okay, so here's what you're supposed to do on a question like this. You're not going to get a number, like you're not going to calculate cosine 19 pi over 18. That's not the point. What the point is they want you to find the reference angle, first of all. Okay, so you gotta, you don't really have to draw it, but you have to know it. Where's 19 pi over 18? Well, let me draw a little circle on here too. Okay, so where is 19 pi over 18? 19 over 18 is just a little bit bigger than 1, right? So if you put a pi on there, it's a little bit bigger than 1 pi. Pi's out here. So where is 19 over 18 pi? Down here. Okay. Okay, so that's the theta. But then what's the theta r? Well, theta r would be just this much, okay? So how much is it? You have to figure that out. So based on the quadrant that it's in, the theta r, the reference angle, is going to be 19 pi over 18 minus pi, right? Just to get that little piece. You work that out, that's 19 pi over 18 minus, get a common denominator, 18 pi over 18 is pi over 18. Feel free to use a calculator for that, okay? So that's pi over 18. Pi over 18. Okay? Now, so already we are like, we're at least 80% done with the problem, okay? So when you found that, that's saying that the cosine of 19 pi over 18 is going to be equal to, first of all, cosine of pi over 18. Okay, that's the reference angle, right? You put the reference angle in the cosine there. But then the question is, should it be positive or negative? Okay, and so you just have to think, in this quadrant here, which is quadrant 3, should the cosine be positive or negative? And so what you need to think is this, basically. So you just think, let's see, down here, the x and y are negative, right? Aren't they negative? In this quadrant down here, they are. So, but the cosine of pi over 18, which is pi over 18 over here, would be positive. So how are they related? This point here and this point here? Well, the x value and the y value are negative in the bottom right. So you just put a negative there, okay? So the two pieces that you have to come up with are the reference angle and whether it should be positive or negative. Okay. And if you're still thinking that you don't know how to know if it's positive or negative, then just keep in mind that in quadrant one, the x value is positive and the y value is positive. And that's in quadrant one. In quadrant two, the x value is negative, but the y value is still positive. In quadrant three, they're both negative. And in quadrant four, the x value's positive. I wrote x though. the x value is positive and the y value is negative. So just sine or cosine is x or y, and then you just need to figure out whether it should be a plus or a minus based on that. All right? So we didn't get a number. This is actually our answer here, right here. That's what you want to finish the problem. Okay? Now what? All right, you are gonna have to find points on the unit circle. So here's another problem from the homework. It says, find coordinates on the unit circle for theta equals 135. Okay, coordinates, that's xy coordinates. So the xy coordinates are, well, what are they? Super easy. Like this type of problem, super easy. Just look at your unit circle. Like literally just, here's your unit circle. Look at it. Where's 135? Right? I can't draw on this, but top left, right? There. There's 135. What are the coordinates? Negative square root 2 over 2, positive square root 2 over 2. Negative square root 2 over 2, positive square root 2 over 2. Right, just from the unit circle. Right, it's right here. I just didn't use this unit circle because I didn't write in the coordinates there, and it's kind of too tightly packed to draw it. All right, so you have to be able to do that. Just look at your unit circle. There's not, you're like, you're not doing anything there. I mean, other than looking at your unit circle. Okay. Another thing they're gonna make you do is they are gonna make you evaluate some sines and cosines on a calculator. So the main thing is if you're asked, to compute sine or cosine on a calculator, just remember that your calculator has different modes depending on whether or not your angle is in radians or degrees. That your calculator has modes, radian mode and degree mode, so that you can make sure your calculator is in the correct mode. So here's a problem straight from the homework. Compute sine 9 pi over 10 on a calculator. Right, and so the thing you got to do is just make sure you understand that's not in degrees, that's radians. So we'll put it right there. They want two decimal places, so easy enough. You're not going to use the unit circle for this. If they're asking for you to do it on a calculator, they do not want you to use the unit circle. So use Wolfram Alpha or something. You can use a scientific calculator, that'll also be fine. 9 pi over 10. And by default, Wolfram Alpha is in, well, it'll basically try to guess whether you want degrees or radians. So if you type it in like this, just see if they mention anywhere that they're using radians. You see it says 9 pi over 10 radians there. So they're using radians. What's the answer? 0.309, but we're supposed to round to two decimal places. So 0.31. That'd be the right answer. Okay, let's see here. All right, so, yeah, let's see. I think that's about it, actually. So, finding reference angles, trig functions on your calculator, how are reference angles related to trig functions on for other angles, and that's about it. And unit circle, make sure you have a unit circle. All right, that is it for today.